This short video will explain the theory and how to build a system to collect electricity. Please review the liability waiver. This is general guidance only. The atmosphere has a voltage gradient. As you go up in elevation, the voltage increases. To collect this voltage, let's install an antenna and a ground. Elevate your antenna about 5 meters off the ground. Now, with your antenna and your ground connection, place a capacitor between the two. And with your metal roof and your grounding rod, you will get enough charge accumulating in the capacitor until it exceeds the voltage rating. Here's a video showing this. Now, to prevent that, the way to do that is to install a spark gap, as shown here. And that spark gap is adjustable so that you can adjust at what voltage the spark gap pops. As you can see, when it pops, the voltage is going to ground. Now, what we can do is we can put an electromagnet in there, a solenoid, such that the armature is moved and it causes the ratchet wheel to turn, as you can see. Depending on the setting of the spark gap, that sets the speed of the ratchet. Now, if it's improperly designed and the gap's too large, then you can destroy your capacitor and your system. In 1901, this patent was issued to Nikola Tesla. But today, we can convert the AC to DC using diodes and capacitors. However, this is a simple design, and we can enhance that by installing a Grinacher quadrupler. This boosts the voltage about 4 times, enough to drive a circuit to charge a battery. And that system, this circuit was set up and designed in 1913. Depending on your system, you can generate lethal shock potential here, so be careful. Now, if you have a metal roof and you attach a cable to it and you insulate the metal roof and insulate the cable, you basically have an antenna. And then with a good ground connection or several grounding rods connected to the circuit, you will be able to charge a battery. Now, what you're collecting are the electromagnetic waves from the electromagnetic spectrum across all the frequencies, because depending on your roof design, or your roof, your metal roof, it's not for a specific frequency. So you're getting essentially all of them at different levels. As the frequency increases, the energy of some of these waves, particles, increases to the point where you're getting X-ray and gamma, all being collected by your... Now, in summary, with a good antenna, a good ground, two capacitors that are ceramic or mica, 200 volts, or two 200 microfarad electrolytic 30 volt capacitors, you can build the circuit and charge your battery. By increasing the antenna size and the grounding and the capacitors that you use, you can increase the power. If you're concerned about lightning hitting your roof, generally speaking, lightning doesn't turn corners. So run your antenna line in alignment with your ground, so it most likely it'll mostly go into the ground. Please comment and subscribe. Thank you.